Alright, welcome back, guys. Today we're going to be working on eye color and lip color. We're going to be changing the color of Angelina Jolie's eyes and lips. The file can be found on the resources, so let's get started. So let me go and grab the image. Okay. Alright, so step number one is always going to be to unlock the background. So we'll unlock the background. Now, before we start making modifications, what I'm going to do is duplicate the layer just in case we mess up. So you can see we have two layers. Okay, each of them is a picture of Angelina Jolie. Okay, so on layer one, we're going to start with this. So the first step is going to be to enter quick mask mode. Okay, so down here on the bottom left of the tools panel, we're going to enter quick mask mode. Okay. Then we are going to zoom in on the iris. Okay, we're going to switch over to the brush tool. And in the context menu, we're going to be sure that we select a soft edge. So by soft edge, that means that the edges of the circle looks almost blurry. So this would be an example of a hard edge. This would be an example of a soft edge. So we'll double click on that. Okay, then I'm going to adjust the size of the tool using the brackets, which is located on the bottom left of the backspace button. There's bracket buttons there. Okay, so what we want to do is get the width about the same width as the iris. So that looks about right there. So I'm going to start to dab at the iris. Okay, and as I'm going along, I'm changing the width of my tool just so that it matches up. Okay, now this is the size that you want to go with for the tool. You don't want to make it very small and get the edges because then it'll just start to look like a hard edge brush. And the whole point is for the edges to look a little blurry. Okay, so we're done with the first one. I'm going to hold space bar. Okay, this will allow me to navigate over to the right side. And same thing, we're just going to adjust the width. So here I'm going to go a little bit thicker on the width. And that's good right there. Okay, so we'll hit Control 0 to zoom out. Now there you go. I just changed your eyes to red. I'm just kidding. We're not even close to being done yet. Okay, so this is a good selection so far. So the next step would be we're going to exit quick mask mode. So we're going to click on the quick mask mode. Okay, now you'll notice we have marching ants around the edge of the document and around the iris. Okay, we only want them around the iris. So we're gonna hit Control Shift I, which is a shortcut for inverse. This will inverse the current selection. So we'll hit Control Shift I. And when you do this, you should see marching ants only around the iris of the eye. Okay, now from here, just a couple steps. We're gonna go to Layer, New Fill Layer, Solid Color. Okay, we're going to change the mode from normal to overlay. And then we'll hit OK. Okay, this color picker, the color dialog box comes up, and we can kind of start messing with different colors now. So let's go with like a, I'm feeling purple today, so let's go with the purple. Alright, that looks good. Okay, so if you look in the layers panel, we have the original image, and then we have a layer that has just the modification to the eye. So if I click on the eye symbol, it'll remove the modification and reapply. Okay. Now, if you wanted to go back after this was done, you can click on the purple box in the layer panel. And if we want to try green, we can go to green now. Okay. For this assignment, I kind of recommend you go with something that looks natural, because in the end, I'm going to be grading it based on its ability to look realistic. Okay, so don't go with something too crazy. Alright, so I'm going to repeat the steps. We're going to do her lips, and then we'll call it a day. Okay, so same thing. Layer 0 copy, make sure it's active. We're going to go into quick mask mode. I'm going to zoom in on the lips. We're going to grab the brush tool with a soft edge. Okay, and again, I don't want the tool to be too small. Okay, I'm gonna start with the edges first. And you can hear me dabbing with my mouse. And the reason I dab with my mouse is that so if I mess up, right, I can hit Control Alt Z and I can go back one step. Whereas if you're trying to one shot all of it, right, let's say we get all of this, you're almost at the end and then you mess up. If you undo, you kind of lose all your progress. Okay, so that's kind of why I dab a lot sometimes. So let's continue dabbing. Okay, so that looks pretty good. And we'll go down here. And we'll continue. Okay, the rest is easy. We'll just fill it in. We'll make the tool bigger. Fill it in, make it nice and thick. Okay. Okay, so we're gonna exit quick mask mode. Okay, we see marching ants around the edges and the lips, so we're gonna do an inverse, Control Shift I. Okay, then we're gonna go layer, new fill layer, solid color, change the mode to overlay, hit okay, and then we can try a different, I don't know what are you guys feeling today? Let's go like a purple with the purple eyes, purplish. I know it's not realistic, look, it's not, you know, too realistic, but it looks pretty cool. Alright, there you go. So this is how you would do the modifications. The only thing I require is that you do a before and after so I can see the difference. So to do this, we're going to go to Image, Canvas Size. Okay. The current width is 22, so we're going to make this width 44. Okay. Well, that's a little bit more than 44 because I'm using two monitors right now. So what we're going to do is we want to move over the picture and the modifications at the same time. Okay, so we're going to control click the original layer, well, the layer zero copy. We're going to hold control on the keyboard and select color fill 1 and color fill 2. Then we'll use the move tool and we will drag these to the left, actually to the right. We'll drag it about right here. We're going to make space for the original to be on the left. So to bring over the original, we can go file place. And I'll bring over the original. It's right here. Drag it to the left. Press enter to apply the change. Okay. And then we can use the crop tool to get rid of the excess. So we'll drag this in a little bit. Hit enter. Control 0. Let me minimize this panel and this panel so you can see. And there you go. There's a before and after color change. All right, you guys have a good one.